Hello, my name is Paul Goodman, and this is the video review for Spider-Man Edge of Time. Spider-Man Edge of Time takes Peter Parker, everyone's favorite webhead, and teams him up with a future version of the hero, a man named Miguel O'Hara, who, through some genetic experiment or what have you, has gained his own version of Spider-Man's powers. Miguel is investigating Walker Sloane, a scientist working for the evil corporation Alchemex. Apparently, Walker is looking to use time travel to go back to the past and form Alchemex decades before its original creation, thus ensuring its monopoly over the global market, wiping out any competition, and of course, the usual world domination stuff. Overlooking the obvious time paradoxes, Walker is kind of successful in poking a few holes in the space-time continuum, and it's up to both Spider-Men to set things right in both the past and the future.
Parker, stop screwing around and get me out of this!
Most of the game is split into a mix of hand-to-hand combat and platforming, as you leap around and pummel through pretty much everything that gets in your way, security guards, robots, even doors, on top of crawling slash swinging through the Alchemex building. Both Peter and Miguel have their own set of unique abilities and combat moves that you can upgrade through collecting the portal energy and golden spiders floating around each level. While the fighting can get repetitive at times, the platforming is even weaker, since there aren't a whole lot of open spaces that really take advantage of the Spider-Man's web-swinging abilities, and most of the time you'll just be jumping from point A to B to get to where you need to go. Also, I haven't seen this much vent crawling since maybe the original Half-Life. I was really hoping for some impressive boss fights, or the chance to meet more characters from the Marvel 2099 universe. Sadly though, besides a few quick cameos and one chapter dedicated to saving Mary Jane from tentacle-filled interdimensional rifts, it makes sense in context, believe me. The best you'll get to meeting up with other characters from Spider-Man universe is a few hit-or-miss boss battles that are either really awesome or really frustrating. There's an intense duel against Anti-Venom which I really liked, especially since in a departure from the rest of the game, I could take him on as both Peter and Miguel, but that was followed by a ridiculously aggravating battle against Black Cat and her army of clones. Without getting too far into spoiler territory, there are a few comic book style plot twists that introduce some other major villains to take on, but the rest of the time you're just beating up the same old robotic guards and failed experiments. Another missed opportunity is the whole concept of time travel itself and how one's actions in the past affect the future. There's a couple of points in the game where manipulating time is a key objective, such as Peter needing to smash up a cybernetics lab to prevent a giant robot of doom from killing Miguel. Several of these points occur throughout Edge of Time, and you don't really have any control over how they turn out. The time distortion stuff is just there to move the plot forward. It's a shame that there's no way to make things easier or harder for yourself by not achieving an objective in time, or through picking from one of several routes. Spider-Man Edge of Time isn't bad, but it isn't great either. The story is probably one of the main appeals, and the game is engaging enough even though it's repetitive, especially after you have to force open yet another door. What holds it back is a missed potential with the time manipulation, the simplified platforming sections, and the lack of iconic Spider-Man characters. Seriously, where's J. Jonah Jameson spouting expletives about missed deadlines? That would have been a cool boss battle to see.
Oh, Jonah, indoor voice, okay? I'm trying to get Mary Jane on the phone.
People lionizing that freak. Next thing you know, there'll be a musical about him with a chorus line of dancing Spider-Man.
I'd pay to see that.